Health Focus is brought to you by National Medical Stores, NMS. Passionate about your life.
Professor, welcome to this interview. Let's start with understanding what the new strain is and what we know about it so far.
Thank you very much. The new strain of SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19 virus is a new strain that was first recognized in the United Kingdom sometime in September, which has mutations. Yeah? Viruses do mutate. And even this virus, we know, has been mutating. But these were many significant, many mutations at the same time, 14. And in some cases, more than 14. Mutations, meaning there are changes within the genetic composition of this virus. And also some parts are deletions, where some parts of the genome have been deleted. So this was new and strange. And what has been found out so far is that it's easily transmissible. Initially, they were talking about 70% more transmissible, but some new data coming up is putting the transmissibility slightly lower. So apart from that, nothing else has been found unique, but a lot of studies are going ahead. At the same time, but independently, another variant also was recognized in South Africa around October, again with independently, again with some mutations. Some are shared with a UK strain, but slightly different. So that makes it a new, sort of new, not the normal way these viruses should have mutated within this time.
When you talk about mutation, what do you mean?
It's a change of the genetic composition of the virus.
When you say highly transmissible, does that refer to very contagious?
Yes. You start seeing a rise in the number of individuals who have this strain compared to the older strain within a period of time. You can compute and find out how likely this is being transmitted from one person to another. Because this mutation is mostly around what they call the spike. And that is the region that attaches to our body.
Does this make it more lethal, in quotation, or more deadly, you may want to say?
At the moment, there's no evidence of that. But studies are going on. There's no evidence that it leads to more severe disease, but more studies are being carried out and being followed. So the only characteristic so far is that transmissibility. But there's a lot of interest to find out whether these changes lead to more severe disease, whether these changes will affect the response to vaccines or to testing or to therapy. And this week, we had a meeting together with other colleagues, including WHO, UVRI, and others, to plan how we can now start very careful sampling, yeah, so that we can target those groups, individuals that are likely to have this strain. For instance, who are traveling in from countries where this strain is. So in summary, I can say, so far, we have not detected this strain. And we have done quite a number of sequences of the viruses in Uganda.
Does this have an impact on the vaccines that have, you know, shown some efficacy of, you know, close to 90%?
That is one of the questions people want to see, and it's of concern, because that spike region that has the mutation is very important for vaccines. So far, there's no evidence for that, but that will continue to be studied. It will be studied in the labs. It will also be studied in populations where vaccination is taking place. It may not, but it's an area of great interest.
Should that worry us as Uganda?
Not to the extent of closing the borders, but we need to intensify our surveillance. To see whether the strain is there. If there's any indication that yes, there are particular groups or entry points then that's why we need to start really taking in these measures. But for now, I think the most important thing is to intensify our survey. And if we find any weak areas that could allow the virus to enter and spread, then we'll do that. But generally, I must say, whether we have the new strain or the old strain, for now, the control measures are the same. It's the same, even in the, where the strain is. The prevention measures should remain. It should not change anything. We need to continue with our putting on masks or hand washing, distancing, so that, and that is the key thing, prevention of spread. So that has to continue.
All right. Thank you very much, Professor, for your time.
National Medical Stores, NMS, passionate about your life. With support from the Ministry of Health, procure, store, and distribute essential medicine and medical supplies to all government health facilities in Uganda.